Sohail Seth, Managing Partner of Counselage, joins us. V. Krishnaswamy, Senior Sports Writer and Commentator. Atul Vasan has been backing the BCCI. I don't think, Atul, tonight maybe you have changed your position. Ajay Shirke, Treasurer of the BCCI, Member of the IPL Governing Council, Member of the Disciplinary Committee and President of the Maharashtra Cricket Association. Four hats he wears. And he's back on the News Hour tonight. Thank you very much, Mr. Shirke. Saad Bin Jung, former Ranjit player, is joining us from Lahore. Thank you very much, Mr. Jung. Good to have you. Arjuna Ranatunga, my first question is to you. Former captain of Sri Lanka. I'm sorry, Saad Bin Jung is from Bangalore. Yes, I got that. Arjuna Ranatunga, you know, this is prolonged episode. Is it hurting just Srinivasan now, or is it hurting the entire game of cricket?
I think what my personal view is, Srinivasan should have resigned a couple of days back. He should have had the morale to take a decision, especially when his family member is involved in this matter.
Right.
He should have resigned, allow the investigations to happen. And if everything goes right, he could have come back. I think that should have been the case.
Yeah, but he's not doing that.
I know this is all about power. I think we have seen this happening in the past, and we can see it happening again.
Point taken. Ajay Shirke, what changed between yesterday and today was Sharad Pawar coming out and taking a position.
Yes, sir.
Right. How many more people will have to come out for Mr. Srinivasan to look at this whole issue in the mirror? Have you spoken to him?
No, I have not spoken to him, and I have not spoken to anybody else either, because whatever I had to say, I think I have made very clear yesterday, and I have come back on
it. No, be a little clearer.
So,
I would like you to be a little clearer, because what is... No, Mr. Shirke, please, you know.
No, I am coming to your point,
yeah,
that how many more people... I have not lost sight of your question. How
yes.
many more people is what you are saying?
Yes.
Now, the question here again is of Mr. Srinivasan, who has made it very clear right from day one that he is not going to resign. Now, the perception of the board, the credibility of the board and the perception in which the board is operating is taking a hit, and it is, you know, taking a hit increasingly so. And I think the time has come that we have to really now address this issue. Otherwise, all I can say is, and everybody, all of us, we would, and especially a person like me who is not really in the run or in the, I don't look at, you know, what is my future in the board or in, it doesn't matter to me at all. I think that we have to look at this issue a little more deeply, and we have to really, really answer this call once and for all, so that this continuous media speculation and, you know, the, and the resulting damage to the image of the board is put to rest.
No. Watch. You're coming close. Watch. It's coming close. He's coming. Mr. Shirke is coming close.
Can I ask a question?
Make it brief.
Mr. Shirke, if I understood you well, this is Boria. If I understood you well, you are saying if Mr. Srinivasan does not see the writing on the wall, he's actually pushing you to also consider leaving this board. Am I right in understanding that?
Well, that is a very perhaps I think Boria, you know me personally, so you might have jumped to that conclusion.
So that's
that's an admission. I want Mr. Shirke.
Is that an admission?
Mr. Shirke.
Is that an admission?
Mr. Shirke, is that an admission that we are correct in assuming, Mr. Shirke?
That
you too, you've had enough. You've had enough with this drama. Yes.
you can call it whatever you like, but the question is that I will speak for myself, that if we don't come to an amicable situation, people like me will lose interest in such kind of things.
That's
because I think we come to this board, and all of us, and I'm not speaking only for myself, there is a lot of people here who do a lot for the board, And the public perception is taking a hit, and it's just going from bad to worse, and we need to really, really address it, not in the interest of anybody or in the interest of the sport, but in the
Mr. Shirke, you are, what you are saying here today is this, and Mr. Shirke, you know, today between you and what you want to say, between what you are saying and what you want to say, with the greatest of respect to you, is a thin veil. In fact, not even a veil, I would say a transparent fishnet of diplomacy that you are putting around your words. Take away that fishnet of diplomacy, Mr. Shirke, because what you are saying, what you are, right, Sohail, you think there's a fishnet of diplomacy in what Mr. Shirke is saying, right? Sohail reads that right. Yes, Sohail. Here, Sohail says it's interpretation of what you're trying to say.
Mr. Shirke, this is the time for men to be men and cowards to step aside. This is not the time for polite discourse. It is not the time for saying we are searching for an amicable solution. I respect you for reading one message right. The public, the people of India, and the people of any diaspora which watch cricket are disillusioned, dismayed, disgusted with the despicable behavior of the BCCI, represented and epitomized by its president, who has lost all morality and, more importantly, the moral courage to be the president of India's most beloved sport. That is the reality. You can't read the writing on the wall. You're just being naive. Listen to what people of this country want. They want Srinivasan to step away, not step aside or step down. He must remove himself from anything to do with Indian cricket, because we have endured enough shame thanks to him. Number two, Arnob Goswami in his channel ran a campaign against a man called Pawan Kumar Bansal for the right reason. It is not in the fitness of things for people to be dragged out of their homes and shown the door. They must have the morality to walk out of the door with some admission and some remorse. Srinivasan shows none of that. The third, which is the most critical point, Mr. Shirke, is you are a custodian of a sport which is loved by Indians. You are not representing Shirke or Srinivasan or some goddamn lobby. You are representing people of India on a board that governs their most loved sport. For once, allow your conscience to reign and rule rather than purposeful diplomacy. This is not the time to join the Indian Foreign Service. This is the time to be military-like, precision surgery, and tell Srinivasan...
Come on, Mr. Shirke. Okay, well, that's it. Well, that's it. You see, this is... I think that... Go back to the first point. Stand up to be counted tonight, Mr. Shirke. Otherwise, posterity will judge you also as one of the people who came close, but did not say it. In other words, Mr. Shirke, I hate to say this, you're a decent man. But posterity will also judge that Ajay Shirke wanted to say something. But because he was in a position, he too was silent, he too was complicit to this entire and grave error
of undermining the passion of the people who follow cricket in this country.
Yes, Mr. Shirke, your turn to respond. Go ahead.
Yes. Thank you, Mr. Seth. I have heard you out very patiently, and you do make certain points. And let's not write history in a haste, because this whole controversy is very young and there is a long way to go.
Young? It's been on for 9 days. For 9 days. What is the definition history of a young controversy?
What is it in the realm of history? And we have nobody has taken conclusive positions for them to be judged.
Well, is the only question is tonight is self-interest far more important than Indian cricket?
Is ego more important than Indian cricket?
Well, is ego more important than Indian cricket? Krishna Swami wants to come in. Mr. Shirke,
I don't think.
Not you. Not you.
I don't think I have ever acted from a position of ego.
Not
ever
you.
In my
not
life.
You. But your board president, Krishna not Swami, you. Has a question for you tonight. We have a top BCCI official. See, lines are being opened up once again on the news hour. Questions can be put directly to him. This is your opportunity. If you're watching the news hour tonight, a top BCCI official will answer your questions. Krishna Swami.
Mr. Shirke, the controversy has been raging for 11 days, and Mr. Shirke calls it a controversy still young. I don't know how young it needs to be more, you know, maybe a few more months or maybe a few more years. The cricket board's always been like an ostrich, you know. Can't it see the writing on the wall? Maybe Shirke needs to write it there on the wall. I mean, they've just completely taken the entire cricketing community in this country and maybe the world.
Mr. Krishnaswamy, I was responding.
The 60,000 people at Eden Gardens booed the gentleman.
I was responding to posterity writing.
He should have left
that place. Posterity judging me or judging the board. I was responding to Mr. Sohail Seth's comment and Mr. Arnab's statement that posterity will judge me. I said it is. We have not taken any final steps for posterity to judge us.
Mr. Shirke, even while saying that he may not have done the right thing, you are still supporting him. The sad part is that 31 people who do vote there are giving out 23 crores to each of the state associations, gagging them with money, and then having players who don't say anything at the press conference. Then you have millions of dollars in terms of television rights. You have hundreds and thousands of dollars worth in terms of sponsorships. It is an opportunity for all the people out there, obviously, to work as honorary members, but still have access to the greatest power in what Sohail rightly called the most beloved sport of India. The saddest thing that can happen is
one of our viewers.
When you continue to do so, and when the board continues to sit quietly, not take an opinion, not even look at the entire nation, and then get on with its work as if nothing is happening. There were two different planets. One, the television channels baying for Srinivasan's blood.
Let's get Atul Vasan in.
Showing a cricket match as if nothing had happened, with the legends not even speaking a word about it.
Taking the sentiments of Krishna Swami forward, I'm taking a few messages I'm getting just ad hoc. One question, one viewer writes in, Atul Vasa, I'd like you to take that. How can the cricket body of India gag the person who is going to carry the Indian flag at the Champions Trophy?